It's Bucko, it's Captain Bucko. He's coming into your life.
Race, all right. You can make some last minute
what
choices.
Have we got here today?
You can change your gear.
Got a new game?
Car,
well, it's
more.
Not new, no.
Never hurts
it's
to give
such,
everything one more look before you
it's
hit
the latest
track.
One in the motorsport series of Forza. All right? Number 7. So polish up your teeth, get your floss out, and your whitener. We're going to get ready, we're going to get dirty, and we're going to get into this game. And we're going to see what it's all about. So, not long ago, we had Forza Horizons 4 come out. This one, I believe, came out about 8-9 months ago. It might have been the very end of last year. So it's been out for a bit now. What would I say in comparison? Both
this
very great looking. Look at the graphics on it. I mean, look at this. Does that look like a real Civic to you? It does to me. If someone told me this was a game, I'd say, what have you been smoking, Bucko? You've been on some crack. This is not a game. This has got to be someone filming. No, it's a game. It's a bloody game, right? Wow. So, very impressive graphics. We should go a bit more into the graphics. Some of the effects have also put in. When you come up to where there's sunlight, I'm going to show you. He's coming up here. See the sunbeams, Bucko? Look at that. They're coming in through the front windscreen. Now, why is that impressive? You're probably thinking, that's not impressive, Bucko. That's just some sunbeams. It actually takes a lot of graphical power to produce those sunbeams. So, I'm impressed by it. And the other thing it does, you can see it right now if you look carefully, there's reflections of your arms in the windscreen. You get to go through the trees and the sunlight's blinking and it's flashing in your car. Just, it's like real. When it's raining, yes, you get different like weather events, nighttime, daytime, raining. I haven't had hailstorms yet. I've had rain. And rain will sort of make puddles form on the road. And then the puddles reflect the surrounding scenery in them. And that takes up an awful lot of graphic card RAM when you do that. Now, this game is an exclusive game on the Xbox. But it's also on the PC. Now, I've got both the Xbox, the PC, and I've got the Xbox One X. This game on the Xbox One, the original one, doesn't look real really that way. It tones down a lot of these effects, old effects. The One X looks really great, but the one that really, really looks great is the PC version, because you can get a great big graphics card, you can turn the ultra detail up, and set it in 4K, and play 60 frames per second. If you know what that means, basically 60 frames per second makes the game that much more smoother and more realistic. It's a must, right? A must. So on Xbox original, it plays at 30 at 1080p, but like a lot of games, they don't really play at 1080p. They drop down to 720 in some places. Not a big issue though, it still looks great. If you've got a 1X, you're going to get the benefit of having enhanced texture detail with that console in this game. As with a lot of the new games, they're all actually getting made now to look better, play better, and play higher frame rates on the 1X. So graphic-wise, mate, I reckon I give this 5 out of 5 buck teeth graphics. Any better, I don't think. So what about the gameplay? The difficulty is, well, I have a stock car here. It's got basically on a Civic from the factory. Kept it stock. And chucked it on the racetrack and see how it went. How did I get it? Oh, geez. I basically couldn't catch that yellow car in front of me there. There's no way I could catch him with my stock setting. I saw what sort of car he was in. I do manage to catch the second place eventually. But no way I could get number one. No matter what I did, I drove hard and I just couldn't get it. And I was only on average difficulty. So, challenging. One of the problems I've had with some of the Forza games is I don't find them to be that challenging. And I've got to up the difficulty, and then you up it, and then you find it too challenging. It's really annoying trying to find that sweet spot. With this one, it's maybe a bit of the same. It's probably too much of a challenge in some settings and not enough in others. You will get damage on your car if you keep smashing into people like that too. So be warned, but if you can see some damage on the side of the car, there's just scrapes and stuff like that. But yes, you do get damage that affects the steering, affects how the gears change and stuff like that. To progress to another track, you literally have to win your race or come very high up in the point score.
Cup regulations state that
go through all the
given
races on that series, complete your series, and then progress to the next track. Okay, so Buckles, we've changed over now. We've now gone to nighttime. And as you can see, everything's looking a bit different now. The sun's gone, and we've replaced day with night, and the headlights are all on. The road looks a lot different with the lights on it. Nighttime plays a little bit different than daytime. I like the fact they've done this. And another one I had raining on, and that was even better. And the other thing I love is that the time actually goes past on these tracks too. So at the moment it's nighttime. As you see, when I come around and do about three more laps, the sun comes up on lap four, I think it is. It starts to come up, and you see it coming up. I thought that was a pretty nice touch and effect to the game too, that actually has time, and that the time brings about changes just like it would in real life. Sound-wise, what can I say about this game sound-wise? One of the things I didn't like about some of the cars in Forza Horizon 4 was some of the sounds. Go play the Honda Civic and tell me if that sounds like a real Honda Civic. It does not. Oh, that's crap. Sounds like a bloody sewing machine or some crap like that. So, done a better job on this one with the sound. I must say that. It sounds pretty aggressive. And once I fiddled with my tuning and stuff like that, I did do a little bit of work on the tuning. I put an AirPod on it, some bigger spark plugs, better tires, but the AirPod changed the sound of the engine to be that more aggressive induction sound, which you get when you have a better induction system on your car. That's a realistic touch. So the sound is as good as the graphics on this game. It's completely realistic. The road too. I found the feel of the road, just the feeling of it coming through the controller, I found very realistic. One of the things I will one day buy is one of those steering wheels with like a pedal and a clutch and an accelerator, and then you set it up on a chair and you put your TV in front of it. Sit in your chair if you're, it's like being in a real car. If you really want to go crazy, you can buy the ones with the hydraulics and they move around and give you a vibration to crap through the chair. I'm not going to go that far because I think they're about $5,000. So, you know, Bucko was like, eating those ones, so I can't really do anything. But it would be fun to have a gold one. Maybe I'll see one day at a show or somewhere, a demonstration, or alright, so do I like it better than Horizons? Probably not. I'm going to be honest. Probably not. I like the free roam. I like being able to smash signs, go through bars. I like the fact that the seasons change and roll around. I like the fact that Horizons is completely all open world. At the end of the day though, the racing cars, the same as what you are. So, there's really not that much difference. If you're a fan of the motorsport, you're probably a fan of the Horizons anyway. You'd probably even end up getting both games. So I don't see any reason to say, forget Horizons and get this, or the other way around, forget this and get Horizons. I think both are equally great in their own right. And it depends on what you're into. If you're into fixed tracks, or if you're into rolling around. Me personally, I'm not a great race fan. I don't mind it. So I'd probably say Horizons a little bit more, but really, that's just my personal choice. Alright, so what would I score this game? Based on everything that I've said, graphics, performance, sound and realism, I'm going to give it some pretty good marks, Bucko. In fact, I'm going to score it exact same score that I gave Horizon 4, which is 4 out of 5 Bucko. Why am I scoring it the same? Because it truly is just as good. In fact, I think if you look for all the big major review sites, they've all scored it around about that too. Not that I go off their scores, I judge it for myself. But that's what I'm going to do as well. I think it's just equally as good. Here we go, Bucko. Have a look at the sky now. And you'll see what I was talking about before with time gone by. Look at that. The sun's up. It's now morning. The sun's come up. And things are all changing. I really appreciate that. I like that effect that they're putting on. Alright, well, coming up to the end of my race now. So I'll end my radio here. It's a massive game, you're going to be here for a long time. It's 105 gigabytes to install it. So, hope you've got plenty of hard drive space ready for it here. Because I'm running out of bloody hard drive space, to be honest with you. So, 105 gigs. That just shows you how much there is in the game, though. There's a lot. Massive amounts of tracks and textures. You'll be here for months playing this game. If you've got both this and Horizon, you'll be there all bloody year playing. Alright, 4 out of 5 buck tiffs, and if you've liked my review, hit a like and subscribe to my channel. Lots more coming up. And this is Captain Bucko signing off. Cheers, buck tiffs. Have a good one, and I'll see you next video.
Have some fun driving. Good work on the track.